Hello students, today I will explain you the fundamental theorems of calculus. These theorems have no proof, but I will explain it to you with the help of their geometrical interpretation. So what are these two theorems? One is the Rolle's theorem, the other one is the Lagrange's mean value theorem. What does this Rolle theorem state? Let us see. This Rolle theorem states that if f is a real valued function which is defined in the closed interval AB such that it is continuous in the closed interval AB. It is very important that this function, given function, is continuous in the closed interval, but it is differentiable in the open interval. Continuous in the closed interval but differentiable in the open interval. Why it is open interval? That I will explain it to you when I will explain its geometrical interpretation to you. And third is when fa is equal to fb. When these three conditions are satisfied by any function, then there exists at least one real number c in between anywhere in the open interval AB. Here also it is open interval AB, such that f dash c is equal to 0. F dash c is equal to 0. What does it mean? Let us see. Now geometrical interpretation of this. Look here. Suppose this is the function, okay, starting at, this is starting from here P and the ending point is Q, and the corresponding points are A and B. So this point is A, so this point P will be x coordinate is A and so y coordinate will be f, because I am considering this is function, this is your function, suppose y is equal to fx. This curve is representing the function y is equal to fx. So this point A, this point A, corresponding value of function here is fa, so this point is A fa, and x coordinate of point Q is B and y coordinate will be F B. Now according to this Rolle's theorem, let us see whether these three conditions are satisfied. Now first is the function is continuous in the closed interval. You can see here this function is continuous in this closed interval from A to B, means it can be drawn without any break. So it is satisfied. First condition is satisfied. It is differentiable in open interval AB. What does it mean? So it means in between A and B, at every point we can draw a unique tangent. Means differentiability means that the curve has the unique tangent at that point where we say this function is differentiable at this point. If I am saying this is differentiable in A, B open interval, it means from A to B I can draw unique tangents. But because you know at this point P, unique tangents are not possible. At this point you can draw many tangents. Therefore at point A and particularly at point B also, this curve is not carrying the unique tangents, therefore it is not differentiable at point A and B, therefore this open interval has been taken here. Is it clear why it is taken? That open interval, in open interval AB the given function is differentiable. Now come to the third point, that FA is equal to FB. Now you can see here this is your FA, and the same you can see FB, that is also, because this is A, this is B, and this is your FB, and the same point is FA. It shows that FA is equal to FB. This shows that FA is equal to FE. Clear, right? This is FA also. This is FB also. Both of these are same. So all the three conditions are satisfied in this curve. Then, according to the Rolle's theorem, if these three conditions are satisfied for any real valued function, then there must exist at least one real number. At least one. What does it mean? That at least one real number means only one is possible. Like here, if the curve is like this, this is A and this is B. This is A, FA, so this is FA, and the same point is, you can see here, this is FB also, right? So function is continuous from A to B, function is differentiable also, and FA is equal to FB also. So in this case, only one point C lies in between A and B, and here more than one point lie, where, and it must lie between A and B only, such that F dash C is equal to 0, 1. This is very important. What does it mean? Try to understand this. F dash C means what? First of all, what is represented by F dash X? Your F dash X, what does it represent? It represents the slope of the tangent. If F dash C is 0, means the slope of the tangent at point C is 0. And when the slope of a line, tangent is also a line, when a slope of a line is 0, just try to recollect it. Slope of a line is 0 when that line is parallel to x-axis. Line here is the tangent. It means when the tangent will be parallel to x-axis. So now try to find out here on this curve where the tangents are parallel to x-axis. If you draw the tangent at this point, you can see that is not parallel to the tangent, parallel to the x-axis. But if you take it here, then if you draw the tangent at this point, you see here clearly this tangent is parallel to x-axis. Therefore, its slope will be 0. Now you can see here also, if I draw the tangent, then that tangent will be parallel to x-axis. Here also, similarly, the tangent would be parallel to x-axis. It means at this point, the corresponding point, suppose this is C1, the corresponding point, suppose this is C2, and the corresponding point here, it is C3. At these three points, the tangents are parallel to x-axis, therefore F dash C1 is equal to 0, because F dash represents the slope of the tangent of that curve. So F dash C1 is equal to 0 means the slope of the tangent at point C1 is parallel to x-axis if it is equal to 0, and F dash C2 is also 0, and F dash C3 is also 0. It means there are these three points, C1, C2, C3, where the slope of the tangent of the curve is parallel to x-axis. But here, if we see in this curve, here only one point is here, that is C, one only. So it means if these three conditions are satisfied, then one or more than one. At least means one. If the curve is like this, then at least means in this case one. If the curve would be like this, then more than one points. So at least one real number. Here it is only one real number. Here more than one real numbers are there, which would lie in between A and B. A or B ke beech mein hai. Here also you can see these three points are in between A and B only, such that F dash C is equal to 0. It means where the slope of the tangent will be equal to 0, means the tangent will be parallel to x-axis. Hanji students, before starting the questions, let us have a look of these important results which we will use while solving the sums of this Rolle's theorem. All polynomial functions are continuous and differentiable on all real numbers. Then all trigonometric functions are continuous and differentiable. negligible on their respective domains. And we know that sine x and cos are differentiable, continuous on all and also differentiable on all real numbers. And now inverse trigonometric functions are also continuous and differentiable on their domains. Exponential function is also, log x is also, and constant function, all these are continuous as well as differentiable on the respective domains. Now algebra of continuity and differentiability. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and composite function of two continuous functions or differentiable functions are also continuous and differentiable. Okay, so now after this we will start the questions. And you to verify Rolle's theorem for fx is equal to this given function in this on this closed interval. Now first of all, students identify the type of this function. What is it? It is polynomial function. So being a polynomial function, as I told you just before this, that a polynomial function is continuous as well as differentiable on R. Therefore, first of all, we write that we have identified that this is a polynomial function. So being polynomial function, fx is continuous as well as differentiable on all real numbers. Okay, therefore number one, fx is continuous on closed interval. Look here, I have written closed interval because fx is continuous as well as differentiable on all real numbers, therefore it will be continuous in this small interval also. Okay, now second is fx is differentiable on open interval. Check here, this is very important that I have shown that continuous on this closed interval while it is differentiable on this open interval. Now next point is f of a. Now what is a? That is 2. F of 2, that is 2 square 4 minus 5 into 10, 5 into 2, 10, this is 6, that is 0. Now f of 3, b, because here b is 3, because third, according to the third condition, f is equal to fb. Now a is your 2, so I have put this value 2 here to get the value of f2. Now I have put the value of f3, so that is equal to 3 square 9 minus 3 5 is 15 plus 6. Again this is 9 plus 6 15 minus 15 is 0. So we can see this implies f2 is equal to f3. So you can see all the three conditions which are required for the Rolle's theorem are satisfied. So Rolle's theorem tabhi applicable hoti hai jab ye teen conditions satisfied ho. Therefore all the three conditions for Rolle's theorem are satisfied. Therefore there exists a number C belongs to open interval, this open interval 2 to 3, such that f dash c equal to 0. Now find out f dash x first of all. What is f dash x? Let us do it here. F dash x is 2x minus 5. So f dash c, replace this x by c. So this is 2c minus 5 is equal to 0. So c is equal to 5 by 2. C is equal to 2.5. And you know that 5 by 2 means 2.5 belongs to, you have to check whether this point belongs to this open interval 2, 3. Yes, this 2.5 lies in between 2 and 3. Therefore, Rolle's theorem is verified. Rolle's theorem is verified. And if you are asked to find out what is the value of, now, what is the value of this FC point? Okay, it's okay because you have to check the verify the Rolle's theorem, so it is verified. Its Rolle's theorem is verified. What does it mean? कि आपने चेक करना था कि अगर ये तीनों कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई होती हैं तो वो जो तीसरा पॉइंट जो सी पॉइंट
पॉइंट जो निकलना है क्या वो इसी ओपन इंटरवल के अंदर ही आएगा?
यस
आ रहा है, इट मींस रो 0 इज सेटिस्फाइड। वेरी हां जी, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस क्वेश्चन आई वांट टू tell you one important result that I had explained you in my previous lectures also, that whenever a function is differentiable then it is continuous. Means differentiability implies continuity. But continuity of a function is continuous, then it is not necessary that it is differentiable also. It may be or may not be. तो हम इसको ऐसे लेते हैं, अगर आप a b c d पढ़ रहे हैं बेटा, अगर आप d तक पहुंच चुके हैं तो obviously c तो पढ़ के आए हैं ना, तो यानी अगर differentiable है तो continuous तो होगा ही होगा, इसको ऐसे आप याद कर सकते हैं। ओके, अगर आपने a b c अगर continuous तक पहुंचे हो कि function continuous है ये बात आपको पता है, तो हो सकता है आप यहीं पर रुक जाओ, और हो सकता है आप डी भी पढ़ो। यानी कॉन्टिन्यूस फंक्शन जरूरी नहीं है डिफरेंशिएबल हो, कॉन्टिन्यूस फंक्शन डिफरेंशिएबल हो भी सकता है, कॉन्टिन्यूस फंक्शन आगे डिफरेंशिएबल नहीं भी हो सकता। लेकिन अगर आप डी तक पहुंच चुके हैं, डिफरेंशिएबिलिटी तक पहुंच चुके हैं, तो कॉन्टिन्यूटी तो आप पढ़ के आए, यानी कॉन्टिन्यूस तो वो फंक्शन होगा ही। थोड़ा सा इसको ये ट्रिक है अपने माइंड में याद करने के लिए। ओके, तो differentiability always implies that the function is continuous also, but continuity continuous function it doesn't give us necessarily, it is not necessary for it to be differentiable. Okay, so ab ye function diya hai fx is equal to this function 4 minus x square raised to power 1 by 2 on minus 1 to minus 2 to 2, you are to verify the Rolle's theorem. Now students, ab aap kya soch rahe honge, this is the polynomial function, that's why it is continuous as well as differentiable, but it is not a continuous function, your polynomial function. Why it is not a polynomial function? Because in the polynomial function it must be like this powers jo hai x ki jo wo whole numbers mein hona chahiye, but here it is in fractions. ओके, और दूसरी बात, अगर ये ऐसे भी होता, इन दैट केस आल्सो इट वाज नॉट अ पॉलीनोमियल, क्योंकि आप इसकी पावर ऐसे थी और आप इसको लिखेंगे 4x² raised to power -1, मैंने बोला होल नंबर में होना चाहिए, तो यहाँ पर ये फ्रैक्शन में है, यहाँ पर ये नेगेटिव है, तो ना तो ये वाला फंक्शन आपका पॉलीनोमियल है ना ये वाला फंक्शन पॉलीनोमियल है, फिर अब हम इसको कैसे करेंगे? द प्रॉब्लम इज ना हाउ टू डू इट। वेरी इजी, जो भी मैंने आपको रिजल्ट बताया कि एवरी डिफरेंशिएबल फंक्शन इज कंटिन्यूस, तो अब हम इसको डिफरेंशिएट करते हैं और देखते हैं वेदर इट इज वट एवर द डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ दिस फंक्शन इज कमिंग आउट दैट इज वेल डिफाइंड इन द ओपन इंटरवल और नॉट। तो हम सबसे पहले एफ डैश एक्स निकालेंगे, सो इट इज 1/2 4 x² raised to power 1/2 -1 into what is the derivative of this -2x, so 2 we cancel by 2, it is -x/4 - x². okay, so this is f dash x। ab ye bataiye ki ye jo aapke paas differentiation aaya hai ye kahan par well defined nahi hai, jahan denominator 0 ho jayega wahan ye well defined nahi hai, aur obviously jaise hum x ko 2 rakhenge to 2 ya -2 rakhte hain तो वहां पर ये वेल डिफाइंड नहीं है, यानी 2 और -2 के अलावा वेल डिफाइंड है। तो हम भी तो अगर डिफरेंशिएबिलिटी चेक करते हैं तो ओपन ब्रैकेट लिखते हैं ना -2 to 2, उसमें ना तो -2 इंक्लूडेड है ना 2 इंक्लूडेड है, ओपन ब्रैकेट मींस दीज एक्सट्रीम पॉइंट्स आर नॉट इंक्लूडेड, एक्सट्रीम लिमिट्स आर नॉट इंक्लूडेड, सो देयरफॉर इट इज वेल डिफाइंड इन -2 to 2, therefore fx is differentiable. अगर ये well defined है तो differentiation well defined है तो it means fx is differentiable in open interval this. This implies fx is continuous also in open interval this, because every differentiable function is continuous also in the given interval. ठीक है, also ये तो हमारी दो कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई होंगी, एक ये होगी एक ये, डिफरेंशियबिलिटी भी होगी और क्वांटिटेटिव भी होगी. तीसरा f ऑफ a यानी f ऑफ माइनस टू, f ऑफ माइनस टू रखिए तो ये क्या आ रहा है, जीरो. f ऑफ टू रखिए तो क्या आ रहा है, टू रखेंगे तब भी जीरो आ रहा है. तो बोथ ऑफ दीज इक्वल, माइनस टू एंड f ऑफ टू, बोथ ऑफ दीज आर इक्वल. देयरफॉर ऑल द कंडीशंस, ऑल द थ्री कंडीशंस फॉर रोल्स थ्योरम are satisfied. Therefore, there exists a number c belongs to open interval. याद रखिए open interval है. अच्छा यहाँ पर continuous में यहाँ ये, हाँ अच्छा जी, ये तो closed interval होना था continuity में, और हमने जो differentiability show की अभी तक minus two to two open एक interval में की है, तो फिर दो point तो रह ही गई ना जहाँ पर आपको इसकी continuity show करनी है minus two to two. अगर से अगर 4 मार्क्स में आता है तो इफ यू राइट इट डायरेक्टली देन आल्सो इट विल बी कंसीडर्ड, नहीं तो आपको माइनस 2 पर भी इस फंक्शन की कंटिन्यूटी अलग से लेफ्ट हैंड लिमिट राइट हैंड लिमिट वो जो आप लिमिट लेते हैं और एफ ऑफ माइनस 2 करके और राइट हैंड पर भी करके दिखानी पड़ेगी, बट ये आपका चलेगा इस तरीके से. देयर एग्जिस्ट अ नंबर सी बिलोंग्स टू माइनस 2 टू 2 सच दैट एफ डैश सी इक्वल टू 0. तो व्हाट डज इट मीन, डिफरेंशिएशन तो अभी हमने निकाला ही था, है ना, एफ डैश एक्स तो हमने निकाला था, तो आप वहां पर एक्स की जगह सी रख दीजिए. तो एफ डैश सी मीन्स माइनस सी अपॉन 4 माइनस सी स्क्वायर इक्वल टू 0. सो दिस इज माइनस सी इज इक्वल टू 0. सो सी इज इक्वल टू 0 एंड दिस 0 जो आया दैट बिलोंग्स टू द ओपन इंटरवल माइनस 2 टू 2 बिलोंग कर रहा है. इसका मतलब हमारी जो रोल्स थ्योरम थी वो हमने वेरीफाई कर दी कि अगर ये तीन कंडीशंस सेटिस्फाइड है तो एक ऐसा नंबर निकलेगा सी जो कि इस दोनों ये जो एक्सट्रीम लिमिट्स हैं इनके बीच में लाई करेगा जहां पर एफ डैश सी जीरो होगा यानी स्लोप ऑफ द टेंजेंट विल बी जीरो यानी टेंजेंट उस पॉइंट पर पैरेलल टू एक्सिस होगा. देयरफॉर रोल्स थ्योरम इज वेरीफाइड. हाँ जी स्टूडेंट्स, आई हैव टेकन दिस क्वेश्चन एंड दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. स्टूडेंट्स इन दिस क्वेश्चन यू नो इट इज साइन रेज टू 4x प्लस कॉस रेज टू 4x. दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉन्टिन्यूस एज वेल एज डिफरेंशियबल फंक्शन ऑन ऑल रियल नंबर्स एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो वी नो दैट इट इज कॉन्टिन्यूस एंड डिफरेंशियबल फंक्शन ऑल ऑन ऑल रियल नंबर्स. देयरफॉर सम ऑफ दीज टू कॉन्टिन्यूस एंड डिफरेंशियबल फंक्शन विल बी कॉन्टिन्यूस एंड डिफरेंशियबल फंक्शन. तो ये है fx बीइंग sum of two continuous functions is also continuous function in on 0 to pi by 2. Number 2, fx being sum of two differentiable functions is also differentiable function on open interval 0 to pi by 2. Now third point is f of 0. So this is sine raised to power 4,0 plus cos raised to power 4,0. We know that cos 0 is 1. So answer is 1. And sine 0 is 0. So 0 plus 1 is 1. So now sine of pi by 2. Now sine raised to power 4 pi by 2 plus cos raised to power 4 pi by 2. This time earlier it was 0 plus 1 is equal to. This is 0 plus 1 raised to power 4 is equal to 1. Here this time this is 1 raised to power 4 because sine pi by 2 is 1. Its power 4, then cos pi by 2 is 0, so it is again 1. So this is f of 0 is equal to f of pi by 2. All the three conditions required for Rolle's theorem are satisfied. Therefore, there exists a number c belongs to open interval 0 to pi by 2 such that f dash c equal to 0. F dash c is equal to 0. Now f dash c is equal to 0 means I have to take first of all derivative of this. F dash x is equal to 4 sine cube x. 4 bahar power it comes sine ka derivative cos x
प्लस 4 cos cube x और cos का डेरिवेटिव माइनस sin x. सो f डैश c इक्वल टू 0. व्हाट डज इट मीन? 4 sin cube c cos c माइनस दिस माइनस आई हैव रिटन हियर 4 cos cube c sin c इक्वल टू 0. फ्रॉम हियर व्हाट इज कॉमन? 4 sin c cos c कॉमन. सो व्हाट इज लेफ्ट हियर? sin square c माइनस cos square c इक्वल टू 0. Now, I can take negative minus sign common from here, minus 4 sin c cos c, and this is cos square c minus sin square c equal to 0. Why I have taken this negative sign common, you will come to know just now. Sin c cos c, this 4 I have split it like 2 into 2, sin c cos c, and this is cos square c into sin square c. I should split it here only, 2 into 2, okay. So now you can see here, this 2 sin c cos c, what is this? Sin 2c. And here also cos square c minus sin square c. This is the formula, cos of 2c equal to 0. Here again 2 sin theta cos theta, again it is minus sin 2 of 2c, sin 2 theta. Now it is theta is your 2c. So this becomes minus sin 4c is equal to 0, and it means sin 4c 0, and you know that when sin 4c 0 means at what values of this, at what values of x this sin function becomes 0. Kab kab hota hai? Aapka pi ke multiples par. This implies 4c is equal to n pi. So it means 4c is equal to 1 pi, 4c is equal to 2 pi, 4c is equal to 3 pi. I have to take. Then c kya ban gaya aapka? Yahan par pi by 4 aaya, yahan par kitna aaya? Pi by 2 aaya, aur yahan par kitna? 3 pi by 4. Yani 3 into 45 kitna ho gaya aapka? 135 ho gaya. So I want that value which lies. Otherwise, so there are so many values of c are coming, c1, c2, c3. But I want that value only which lies in between 0 to pi by 2. 0 to 90 ke beech mein kaun si hai? Only this value is satisfying. Ye to aapki pi by 2 hai. I don't want these extreme values. Hame to sirf uske beech wali chahiye hoti hai. So this is, only this value is satisfying. So c is equal to, all these are not possible. Therefore, c is equal to pi by 4 is possible. Therefore, and you write down this, pi by 4 belongs to 0 to pi by 2. So, at least one, so bola kam se kam ek to lie karegi. Kar rahi hai, ek to lie kar hi rahi hai na. Ek se zyada bhi ho sakti thi. So, at least one to hai. So, this implies whole serum is satisfied. Whole serum is satisfied. Very much so. Hanji students, I have written here question number 3 of your exercise 5.8. Here in this question it is given, f is a function, it's mapping from minus 5 to 5 to r. It is defined in this way and it is differentiable. And if f dash x does not vanish anywhere, what does it mean? That it doesn't vanish anywhere. It means f dash x is not equal to 0 anywhere. Okay? So this is differentiable, it's given to us. And it is also given to us that f dash x is not equal to 0 anywhere. Then you are to prove that f of minus 5 is not equal to f of 5. So we are to prove this. So let us do it. Solution. We assume that both of these are equal. और लास्ट में हम कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन पर पहुंचाएंगे तो ठीक है हम f of minus 5 is equal to f of 5 ओके हमने मान के चला कि ये दोनों इक्वल है एंड नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू क्वेश्चन फंक्शन इज डिफरेंशिएबल अकॉर्डिंग टू क्वेश्चन f x इज डिफरेंशिएबल अगर ये डिफरेंशिएबल है तो इसका मतलब ये हुआ fx is, this implies fx is continuous also because every differentiable function is continuous also. बताया था ना अगर d पर है तो c तो पढ़ के ही आए हैं ना तो इसका मतलब अगर डिफरेंशिएबल है तो कॉन्टिन्यूस तो पक्का ये है ही है। तो अब आप एक चीज देखिए जरा ध्यान से कि फंक्शन कॉन्टिन्यूस भी है, फंक्शन डिफरेंशिएबल भी है और एफ ए इज इक्वल टू एफ बी भी है, तो क्या दिख रहा है आपको? ऑल द थ्री कंडीशंस ऑफ रोल्स थ्योरम्स आर सेटिस्फाइड। दिस इंप्लाइज हेंस ऑल द थ्री कंडीशंस फॉर रोल्स थ्योरम आर सेटिस्फाइड। इट मीन्स देयरफॉर देयर मस्ट एग्जिस्ट a number c for which f dash c equal to 0, जबकि हमें तो दिया हुआ है कि fx is not equal to 0, है ना? f but we know, but it is given that f dash x is not equal to 0 anywhere. Yeah, at any point. Therefore, जो हमने assume किया that is wrong. Therefore, our assumption that f minus 5 is equal to f5 is wrong. Hence, we can say, hence it is proved. It is proved that f of minus 5 is not equal to f of 5. Hi students, this is also again your NCERT question, question number 2, part 1. Fx is equal to greatest integer function and you are to check whether Rolle's theorem is you are to examine the Rolle's theorem is applicable to this function or not. आपको पता है रोल्स थ्योरम एप्लीकेबल कब होती है? ओनली व्हेन द थ्री कंडीशंस आर सेटिस्फाइड, ओनली इन दैट केस योर रोल्स थ्योरम विल बी एप्लीकेबल टू दैट फंक्शन। तो हम पहले वो तीन जो कंडीशंस है, लेट्स चेक इफ दिस फंक्शन इज सेटिस्फाइंग दोस थ्री कंडीशंस और नॉट। पहली कंडीशन क्या होती है? कॉन्टिन्यूटी, द फंक्शन मस्ट बी कॉन्टिन्यूस। तो अभी तो ये फंक्शन जो है यही पहली कंडीशन पर फेल हो गया। कैसे फेल हो गया? इफ यू recollect that what is the graph of this function, this is 1 2 3 and then it would be 1 and 2, so ye function ki aise hota hai, hai na? This is 2 aise, hai na? To hame ye function milta hai step form mein aata hai, aise step, to function aapko dikh raha hai it is not continuous. At every integral value it is, its continuity is breaking. अगर ये आप देखिए जरा, 2 पर आके continuity break हो गई, यहाँ पर चला गया, 2 की value यहाँ है, ये नहीं है, यहाँ पर आपका 2 से 2.9 तक है, 3 पर ये यहाँ चला गया, 3 पर चला गया, यहाँ ये ऐसे ही है। तो function is not continuous, step graph. तो this given function is not continuous, okay, in open on this 5 to 9, therefore Rolle's theorem is not applicable. आपको तीनों में से जो तीन conditions हैं उनमें से एक condition भी ऐसी मिल जाती है जहां पर आपको ये लगे कि ये function की ये condition satisfied नहीं है, तो वहीं पर रुक जाइए। वैसे तो अगर आप ये देखिए f of 5 देखिए तो दिस इज 5 का ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर 5, एफ ऑफ 9 देखिए सो दिस इज 9, तो दिस बोथ ऑफ दीज आर नॉट इक्वल, एफ ऑफ 5 ऑल्सो नॉट इक्वल टू एफ ऑफ 9, ये यहाँ पर भी नहीं। तो फंक्शन इज नॉट कॉन्टिन्यूस करके ही हमें रुकना है, आगे चेक ही नहीं करना है। तो फंक्शन इज नॉट कॉन्टिन्यूस, देयरफॉर इट रोल्स थ्योरम इज नॉट applicable in this case. So students, today I have explained you what is the Rolle's theorem, I have explained you the geometrical interpretation of that also, and we have done questions of Rolle's theorem also, and in my next lecture I will explain you what is Lagrange's mean value theorem, and we will try some questions also. Till then, goodbye.